What's crackling, everybody? I'm Grandmaster. Welcome back to Citadel Forged with Fire, and I can't promise this is going to be the longest of series. I can't promise this is going to be more than one video, to be honest. But they did come out with a, what they say, massive expansion. So I figured I would come back and I would check it out. I'm going to do a custom game. I'm going to delete my old world. Yes. Permanently delete. Custom game. Okay, so I'm starting a brand spanking new world. I want to go to advanced settings. Have they added or changed anything here? I don't honestly know. Free fly mode is enabled. Inventory weight restrictions is disabled. So I can have as much as I want. Unlimited resources. Ooh, I don't remember seeing that one before. I kind of want to turn that on so I can build whatever I want to build, because the grind in this is excruciating. Knowledge modifier, I don't even... That doesn't matter. Character points, doesn't matter. Damage modifier. I'm gonna leave it at, like, normal for right now. Armor modifier will be at normal for right now, which is just one times. They still have the really crappy sliders, it seems. Mana regen modifier, keep it up, because otherwise it's just boring. As solo play goes, this game, when I originally did it, the reason why it died off is because their solo play isn't fun. It wasn't fun. There wasn't a reason to exist in the world, but now there's quests and all this other kinds of stuff, so I want to check it out. Inventory capacity modifier multiplies the carrying capacity of a player. I'll increase that to max. I don't care about the magic bind. Flying cost, as low as it can possibly go. Speed modifier, I'm turning that down to 1 because it alters the enemies too, which makes no sense. Structure, mana cost, whatever. Build restrictions disabled, throne decay disabled. Time of day, I'm gonna lock it on noon. I lock it on noon. I don't like the darkness. It comes across in recordings really, really bad. Structure decay modifier, so they haven't added anything to the actual player versus player I'm turning off. Experience modifier, yeah. They haven't added anything to the actual amount of stuff you can do on admin, which I feel is probably one of the absolute worst things in this game, is like this like limit that they have, because it's like the grind, even with the max turned up, is excruciating. Like, it wasn't fun. I'm hoping that things will change. Yeah, just continue creating a new thing. Alright, so we have a character creation. Random. Oh my god. No, just go to default again. Just give me hair. That's all I'm just gonna go with the default. Why does the graphics look so bad? I'm gonna have to check those before I actually go into like the full recording. Body. Colors. Can I do hair color? Purple. Is there facial hair? Hair head 1? Hair 2? Okay, this is head type. There we go. I was like, I want a beard. Or a goatee. There we go, that's right. I'm gonna go with the normal of grill. Alright, create character. Yes. Choose my starting location. I'm gonna start right in the middle. And we're forged with fire! I didn't understand. I was like, what is happening the first time I saw this? I remember that, and so I was like, it's forged with fire. It's like, oh yeah. So I guess we're technically being forged by fires. I like how there's just a mouse cursor in the middle of the screen. And we're alive. We're a person. Alright. So, same thing type of thing here. I'm gonna take a quick look at the graphics real fast. Nope, graphics are all still the same. There's no difference there. Alright, speak with you, tutorial quest. Cloth crafted. Okay, so you want me to craft up 5 cloth? I start punching trees. Nope, that tree doesn't work. Okay, well, let's, Yeah, go back to third person. Okay, we have our inventory. Everything here seems pretty similar to what it looked like before. I remember those, though. I guess maybe it's just the place itself could be different here. Alright, well, let's wander out into the world. Take a peek. There should be actual quests now, though. We can actually go on? Like, there's some sort of story? I know I had found a boss place, but then I was told, even in comments, that the boss is, like, basically impossible to fight. When you're playing solo, like, you need a group for a boss fight. Which, I don't know. I mean, Ark, you could do things solo. I did everything solo. And, like, it was how I did boss fights solo. It was possible. No? You just don't even... Okay. Well, let's open up our menu. Add damage, health. Let's add some health. Let's get this. And make our first basic thing. Okay, remember you need to kind of just run around and gather stone, sticks off the ground, pick up wood. Is that enough? Crafting. So we need to craft 5 cloth. Oh, wait. You literally just want me to craft 5 cloth? I already had the resources for it? Oh, apparently we already had the resources for it. I just didn't even realize. Alright, well, let's go to tools. Craft one of these real quick. No, I have to wait until it's done. Alright, hurry up and craft that last one. There we go, crafting. Oh my god, it takes forever. Alright, and we can make a wooden hat too, which takes 5 cloth and that. Alright, well, let's... I guess before I even do this stuff. Ghost orchids. Okay, I'm already sprinting. So I was like, am I sprinting? Yes, that's auto sprint is on. Let's go back up and talk to the lady real quick. So I finished her missions. I assume... Okay, and I got my axe. Yeah. So now I can actually chop trees and everything as well. Oh, it's just a flower on the ground. It's like, what is this? I mean, this game itself doesn't look super bad. I never thought it did. I always thought it looked rather nice. It's one of the things that drew me to it. But I don't know. It was the other aspects of this game. There's a quest up there. All right. The only quests they had originally were daily quests, which was It's not enough to keep me entertained. Me personally, I'm sure some people went and have a problem with it, but I personally didn't find it entertaining. Okay, let's talk to you again. Huh? Complete the mission. Mm-hmm. Fresh berry salad. Alright, are you giving me the resources for this? Let's go back to this. Add some health. Got a bunch of points, honestly. Health. Alright, craft. Is it here? Fresh berry salad, craft. What do you need for it? Mushrooms, ghost orchid, crowberry? Okay. Must have given me the supplies for it. Huh? All right, complete the mission. Uh-huh. Wait, I just did it. Uh-huh. Fresh berry salad crafted, complete. Please unequip any quest items. What? Oh. I didn't realize I put it in my hotbar. Huh? Okay, there we go. Huh? Okay, you want wood collected, stone collected, and runes collected. Well, the runes are easy. Boom, we got our wood. Our runes or whatever. Get the stone from this tree. Or stone from this tree. The stone from here, there we go. Okay, we got stone, wood, and rune collected. Mm-hmm. Complete. I do have the experience modifier. The beginning levels are fast, just like any game. I do remember that. Okay, so your next one, Nature's Essence. Is it one of those up here? Or is that outside? Craft Haste Spell? I don't remember there being one in here. Because it's like the the green ball things. Alright, well, let's go back to this. Add health. Carrying capacity doesn't matter because I have that turned on, so we have as much as we want. Alright. You. Good, good, good. Oh no, it's actually knowledge. Give me my clothing. I can make the magic bracelet, but I don't feel like that's worth it right now. Okay, craft up you. No, I need more cloth. Okay, so let's head out, see if we can find our nature things. I've unlocked a new crafting recipe. It's like this bubble around here that keeps you safe in PvP. Alright, fall down. I guess we'll just kinda head out into the open world. Find this nature stuff. I don't remember exactly what it was near. Don't see anything around here. Which I always preferred this in third person, yeah. It's like, first person is nice for, like, screenshots, kinda? But third person, oh god. Ooh. It just slid down a mountain. Third person just gives you more of a view. Everything that's around you. Yeah, 5 stone. I think I probably end up will be turning on when I go to build anyways, the craft anything. Just because that was probably one of the most excruciating things. Besides the fact that you can't rotate, which I never understood the logic there. Like, why not have a rotate option when building? But it's just the choice they went with. Yellow pine, that's how I make clothing. Mushrooms. Okay, so we just need nature essence. And then I don't know if on custom games specifically the spawn rates have changed at all. Because that was always one big issue in the past too. Was spawn rates. Like, nothing spawned until like you were in the game for like almost an hour sometimes is what it felt like. Crowberry? Okay. Just gonna grab everything I could see as we search for our nature essence. Craft a haste spell. Wait, did you give me a nature? No, because it would have told me to, right? Yeah, no, it didn't give me a nature one. I didn't think so. Alright. Leveled up again. Give me all of this so I can make some cloth. Just add to health. Crafting. Cloth. Craft up 10. Alright, while it's doing that, I can sit here and still gather. Grab you. I didn't even grab it. Nature essence. Well, let's look at our map. What do we have around us? Is there any pools? There's a natural acid pool right there. Okay. Yep, there they are. It was like, basically, it was like around the natural acid pool, you could find nature essences. Around the mana pool, you could find one of them, which I didn't understand even what those things were in the beginning. They're just balls of stuff. I had no clue. That's how you get the essences. Alright, obviously don't want to jump in there because it's an acid pool. I'm just going to go up top. Get them this way. Okay, give me... So please give me some essences. That's right. Isn't this one you can't just hold the attack button on, you have to actually keep clicking. Alright, well, give me that. There we go. I have enough, I can make a haste spell. So, open up crafting. Keep opening up. I hit tab thinking that's the right button, but it's not. Okay, go heal. It's already there. Put this on there, and it's self. Extract, geyser, pounce. Okay, well, that doesn't help me. Is it on clothing, then? Cane? Haste. Right there. Put that on that part. Craft spell. Use the haste spell. Alright. Now I'm faster. Okay, so I can go back up, talk to that lady again. I'm gonna talk to the person that's up in the tower, too. They may have a mission that actually is not just tutorial-based. On cooldown? Oh, I see it. I was like, what? Okay. Is there more knowledge, more stuff I can unlock? Doesn't seem like it. Wands and staffs. I'm gonna go with the wand. I think I always remembered that being the best in the past. Oh, and then there's other things we have unlocked, too. They're basic wood structures. How many points do I have right now? I have 4 points left. We need a throne, storage chest. That costs 2. Conjuring cauldron costs 2. Fire pit costs 1. Build that one up real fast, and there's the forge. Right, use haste so I can go faster up there. The one thing I miss right now that I'm a little sad about is the fact that I don't have well, my castle's gone is one thing. It sucks. I didn't even think about that. I deleted the world, but yeah, that means my castle's gone. But whatever. That's the whole point, is I wanted to start from the beginning and see how much has actually changed since early access start. A person was up in what, this tower? What is going on up there? Is that just a flag? Unlock fast travel. There we go. It wasn't you. Which tower are you in? Oh, over there. Okay, whatever. Let's use haste. Go back down into this place, talk to this lady. Did your mission.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, what else do you want me to do? Craft extract spell? Alright, well, I guess I could do that. That'll actually work. Craft. Health. Go back to the spells. Use this. Extract. Right there. Put that on the main one. Here we go. So now I don't even have to, like, I can just sit here and do this. Okay. Complete. Use extract spell, wood gathered. Alright, there you go. Did it. I already have a bunch of wood.
Mm-hmm.
Craft a fire pit. Do I have that? Okay, there we go. Forgot I actually set up my own hotkeys. What? You're where? I learned it, right? Yeah. Fire pit. Craft. Fire pit. Oh, wait. You're weird, aren't you? Gotta go to build mode. Wood magic? Is it in magic? Small? No, that's throne. That's that. Fire pit. Okay, made a fire pit. Forgot that there's like a weird building menu. Okay, get out of that. Paste again.
Mm-hmm.
Talk to you. Complete. Now what do you want? Salted boar. Okay. Did you actually give me boar? Yes, you did. Alright. So, I guess we'll go to our fire pit. I literally could have put the fire pit right there. Extract. Salted boar. Craft that up real quick. I like the screen. Little annotations on the side. Okay, no, not you. I had to actually pick up the bag. Mutal. Alright, we crafted your boar.
Huh?
Complete.
Huh?
Interact with travel portal. I already did. I hope it still counts when I go to interact with it again. Technically, I already activated it. Interact with travel portal. Okay, yep, that counted. Good. Jump. Utilize the speed that I had. Alright.
Huh?
Complete.
Huh?
Speak with Grimlock, or Grimbok. Okay, where are you at? You're over here? Super speed. Is that the dude that was up in the tower? No, you're actually really far away. Alright, well, person up in the tower here, what do you have for me? So there's a mission up here, and I think originally it was like the blue missions were the ones that were daily missions. It's got like a bear thing in here. Evanhand Hindcliff, side quest.
What?
30 cloth crafted. Alright, I'll do that, why not? Oh, I'm already at 25? Alright then, so I'll just add a little bit more. Craft. Resources. I mean, technically I only need 5, but I don't see a point in not crafting it all at once. Okay. I can't even walk in here. Got a chest in here. Flag. Forge. The picture of an orc on the wall for some reason. Alright, two more and then I can turn this side quest in. Because I think this... I don't know. I honestly don't remember if this... That's what this was or not.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, iron ingots crafted. Can I use your thing? No. Alright. We'll just have to come back for that one. Looks like our mission's actually out here. Please don't die. Please don't die. Oh, no. I'm good. I know there's fall damage, isn't there? Maybe there's not? I don't remember. Alright, we just gotta go out into the world, though. We're done with our, at least, missions for that lady. Oh, God. Sliding down the mountain. Please don't kill me. Yeah. Alright, go fast. This guy is really far away. Alright, well, I guess I'll just gather things as I go. If I remember right, that was actually the fastest way to level up, too, is just literally sit here and just gather up all these different things and everything as you travel. Like, the actual resource gathering was... You got more experience for it than you ever did fighting anything. Go over here. I think there was a person in here, in all these. Yeah, this is the ones I was talking about. Daily quest. Wild elk defeated. Why not? I'll accept your mission. I'm gonna kill you. Oh wait, I can't, because all I have is the extraction spell. Oh no, I screwed up. Oh wait, I could quickly change that though. We made a wand. Put that in the main hot bar. Put you in the sidebar. Okay, so I can do arcane beam, arcane missile, haste, arcane step. Let's do arcane beam on the left side. Craft spell. I think there was a Nature's Touch, Roots of Wrath. Yeah, do that one right here. Okay. Now I actually have a attack. Where'd you go, dear? I need to kill you. This is why I like third person. Better idea. What is happening? Where'd you run off to? Don't see you anymore, man. Just took off. Alright. Haste. Deer just disappeared. Oh well, what can you do? I'm just gonna keep going towards that mission. Maybe I'll find more deer on the way. Who knows? Alright, grab. I think that's what I need for potions, is these blue ones. Which are kind of vital. I liked aspects of this game. There were certain aspects that were awesome. That's one of the reasons I wanted to come back and check it out with this update. But there were certain things that were such turnoffs of it that I just couldn't... I couldn't continue. And then I was like, I just wanted to explore the world at a certain point, but the problem is, I always ask myself a question, why do I exist in this world? And if I can't answer that question, then I literally don't see the point of continuing. And with this one, it's like, I couldn't answer that question. Could not honestly answer the question. But now, the reason to exist is complete quests. See the actual story that they've added. Is there a cave? Yeah. I don't know where I'm going. Whoa, it's a crazy looking cave. All right, what's up, dude? Speak with you. I completed the mission. Achieve 10. I already did it. It's already done. Okay, boar's defeated. Okay, so now you want me to go defeat a boar? Now, the question is, have they spawned? There's a bear. Freaking me out, man. Okay, down here was where orcs were. I saw those. Some free experience. Oh wait, I have enough now. I should be able to craft up. Add health. Add damage. Go to crafting. Can I make this now? No, I need more cloth. Oh, I actually turned the cloth into that dude? No. No. Alright, whatever. Craft that up right now. So yeah, no, I didn't make it already. I had to make sure I hadn't made it already. Okay, so we need to find a boar. Which is, like, the big thing I'm hoping that they've changed. That it'll actually be possible to find a boar. Right? Oh, it's a log. This is, like, another cave below, or...? No? See, the world seems so empty. There we go, boar. Got a boar. Whoa! That was amazing. I don't remember that spell being that cool. Loot all. Alright, I got the boar. I'm good. Haste. Run back over to dude. Actually, didn't expect it to be that fast. 5 of 10 iron ingots crafted. I never crafted any. I don't know how it says I have any done. But okay. What's up, dude? It's like, what is this? There's like some weird... Is it just me seeing this? Or is this like... Yeah, there's like some weird thing going on in here. Okay, we killed a boar. Bear is defeated. Hey, I know where a bear is. I actually saw that one. You were over here. Over here a minute ago. Where'd you run off to, man? Saw that hanging out right here. What's that? As far as the maps go, map goes too. I want to know. No, not you. Get out of this. I pushed the wrong button. So we zoom out. I don't know if the map actually got bigger or not. I feel like it's the same size. I don't know. They said it was all the new stuff was added to this current map, so I assume it's gonna be whatever they added somewhere near here. Ooh. Nope. Nope. Not yet. Okay, go back to crafting. Craft me up now that I have enough. Some armor so I don't die instantly. Alright, I can actually get the forge going. A workbench going. A tailoring bench going. A respawn place. Alchemy. Mana generator, which I don't think I need this yet. Alright, and that's their building stuff. There's a wooden trap door, yeah, that never actually worked in the past. We got food we can cook up. I do want a health potion, mana vial, dyes I don't care about, but I do want the broomstick. Might as well learn saddles. Upgrade already to a better one. Requires 2 points. Already upgrade to better armor, in fact. Requires 2 points. Okay, so I can't do that yet. Alright, we'll switch back to this. No, actually, give me the haste. I can find where this bear disappeared to. Burr, where did you go? I didn't expect you to wander too far. You were over here a minute ago. Possibly up there? I'm not sure. Alright, I'm just gonna go over here. Wildwood, level 1 through 12. And this seems like a place that wouldn't be too bad to just build like a little wooden base at. As far as building goes, let's go to building real fast. Go to wood. Yeah, it takes 10 wood. Brutal. Takes 10 wood and what? No. 25 wood? Is that what I'm seeing here? Yeah, see, that's just nuts. That's just nuts. Like, that's something I could never... This is one of those games I could never play on official. Because it's like, this is with the increase. You get 10 wood per amount you absorb or whatever. So 10 wood per thing you absorb. that's a times 5. Or times 2? No, it's times 5, I think. So that means you only get, like, 1 wood. 2 wood. At a time? And it costs that much to build one foundation. Which is craziness. So there's a very real possibility that if I do continue this, and it's not even a real possibility, if I do continue this, it will 100% be with changing it so I don't require stuff to build the floors. I'll put you here. I need at least one more wide. Because you need enough room that you can actually start putting all this stuff down. So, yeah. 100% will not be, will be done with building on other methods. Because, I mean, I could see, I like the building mechanics in this other than the fact that you can't rotate. You just have to look at a specific place and put it that way. So, like, the building pieces look cool and everything. Alright, well, I want to kill this bear. Where'd the bear go? Why did you run away? You were there earlier, but now you're not. I need to murder you. Come back. There's nothing here. This makes me sad, because the world is as empty as it was before. Alright, well, I guess I may restart the game in just a second to set it to infinite build options. So I can build up a base that looks cool and not spend 3 hours farming for it. I know it only costs as much as it does right now because of the foundations. Like if I go back to build, the walls themselves are 25 a piece. That's still expensive. How little you get. Like, I feel like Ark is the perfect game when you go to the cost of what you're paying for what you're getting. Like, the grind and everything for building stuff isn't excruciating. It never really was, even on official. It was a little bit more than I had time for, but not at the time I first started playing Ark. Mostly because that was the only game I played. Now, it's definitely, I don't just play one game. I can't just play one game. My brain has gotten to the point that I play one game only, and I will lose all interest in that game very quickly. Where'd that bear go? Seriously, it was like right there. I remember being like, there was a bear. I don't want to necessarily restart, because if I restart, then everything disappears again except for these. Camps, they're the only places that you could always find things at. There was a camp, there was always the enemies there unless you killed the enemies. Alright, well, yeah, I'll see you in 1 second, I guess. I'm gonna restart the server thing, custom game, and turn on infinite build stats. Alright, so now I should be able to build everything. You? Yeah, okay, good. So now I can build whatever I want. Whoop, that's not what I wanted to do. Remove. Build. This is what I mean by the stupid. Why do you not allow for rotation? Makes no logical sense. What the frick? What? Get rid of the scaffolding. Why is the scaffolding there? Weird. Whatever. I don't care. It works. Alright, so let's go to building floors. And now I remembered also why I had the knowledge points turned up. Because that way you could... Okay, no. Rotate you here. There. Now we have our entrance. With the knowledge points turned up, you could actually unlock everything. Which I think, if I did the math right, you can't do as a solo player. You can't actually unlock all the stuff. Okay, let's put you right here. No, diagonal wall. Boom. Boom, boom, and a boom. Okay, straight wall, right there. Is there no windows? Okay, no, there's windows. Oh, you put them in after the fact. Okay. Well, let's do large door. No. Let's do small door. Normal small door. Oh, I need to put the... Okay. I get it. So let's put our wall on. Put our wall on. Put our wall on. Can I just start stacking you up? Right there? I'm gonna make a little tower with this. It's one of the reasons I like this thing. Build you, build you, build you, and build you. I feel like that's probably good. Sloped wall? Nah. Okay, go door. Place the door. Which side was the door? Can I just walk right in? No? Okay. Can I put this right here? Yeah. Alright, so I can put a door on either side. Okay, get out of this. Go to doors. Place the door right there. Okay, that works. So everything's set up there. Then let's go to roofs. So up at the top, I want you facing inwards. Okay, I guess getting out of this entirely. Okay, get out of this. Go back to first person. Maybe first person will be a little bit easier to build with. I need to put a throne down somewhere. So I'll just put the throne down right here in the back. It's a little floaty. That's fine. Magic. Small. The generator right next to it. I don't think I need that yet, but I don't remember. Respawn in front of it. Put a storage box over here so I can put any building stuff that I need. Okay. Therein lies the problem. That's right. Stuff is big. Stuff is really big. So if I put this here, make a second floor. Need a small piece. Small piece. Alright, well, one of these doors is gonna have to disappear. Or it can be there still, but I'm just gonna have a stairway on this. Straight down. Can you... Other way? Other way. Other way. Right there. This is so... Developers, what were you thinking with this freaking not rotating crap? I don't get it. I don't get it. I mean, I guess I could just sit here and I could do this. This will be fine. I'll just make a freaking special thing. Alright, whatever. Get out of this. Insane. Magic. You. No, it's the bigger one. Okay, which is the workbench that makes it so I can make... I don't remember which one makes it so I can make the... I think it's the workbench. Get out of this. Open you up. Add to health, whatever. Tools. Traveler's broomstick. Craft that up for me real quick. So I'll just fly up and put it up there. It's the only thing I can think of because there's no way to... there's no way to put stairs in here. There's no, like, middle ground stairs. So you basically... I knew you needed a big building if you actually wanted to put all your stuff inside. Like, this right here would have taken me, like, an hour just on my increased gathering to do. And then the broomstick will just make it so I can find stuff easier. Being in here right now will hopefully make it so... I don't have... Stuff will be spawning outside while I'm in here. That's kind of my hope right now. Let's go back to build. Might as well build some more stuff while I'm sitting here. Where's windows? Large window. Put you right behind there. Now, why does it not put any window frames on there? I feel like that's weird. Eh, whatever. Okay, get out of this. Loot all. Did it automatically put it on there? Yes, it does. Okay, so now I can just fly up here and just turn this off. It is what it is. Go to knowledge. Knowledge. Okay, so I increased my knowledge power so I can actually get everything. go back to the building. Whatever, get the trapdoor. Torches, doesn't matter. Defense, wooden spikes, doesn't really matter. I guess I don't... Yeah, torches. Wall-mounted light pack. Go here, we can get foods, we can get potions. I'm gonna unlock these as well. And the crafting of this. I can actually have armor so I don't die in two hits. Oh, I don't have enough points. Alright, you. Build. Menu. What did I just push? It showed that. Is it the build menu? I guess. Okay, go back to the ceilings. Right there. Right there. Right there, and right there. We need slanted. Okay, I was like, please actually go the right direction. Okay, and then we just have this one right here. Flat roof. Flat roof needs support. Really? Can't just put that there? Alright, well then I just don't care. We're just gonna have a hole to fly in and out of the base head. That's just the way it's gonna be. Okay, go to magic. Go to the bigger thing. I'll put the forge right here. I'll put tailoring bench right here. And I'll just put the alchemy literally right... Well, no, I can put a ceiling on this. That'll be fine. Wood, ceiling, here. Okay, go back to magic. Right here. Alchemy! Right! Why? Why can't I put this here? What is the logic behind this? Colliding with stairs. There's no flipping stairs here! What? Whatever. Okay, so we have our building set up. Hey, there we go. Stuff's actually spawned. Get out of this menu. Kill the deer. Kill the elk. Kill the elk. Give me the haste. Boom, take you out. Okay, loot corpse. Loot all. Just need to find a bear, though. Which, I mean, this is one time speed. And flying around. If you fly down, you go faster. But if you're just flying around like this... Yeah, it is brutal to go places. But you can't go very far anyways. If you go out of a zone where you're located, like this is level 1 through 12, if you go to anything higher than that, you will get destroyed so quick. It is brutal. Okay, so the mission is to get 10 iron ingots. Can I just, switch to this? You iron? Or are you stone? Yeah, this is iron. Okay, so I have enough, I can actually do that. Here we go. Let's go cook that up real quick. I mean, you don't haste this game. No. No, it doesn't. I just turn that off and just run. It's faster to run. Grab these so I can make cloth and not such. Alright, let's go back inside. Boop. Alright, then I need to come up up top to the forge, interact with you. Make iron ingots. I need to make 10. There we go, so that mission's working on. And I just need to find a bear. So I'll see you in a second when I find a bear. So this game still has extremely broken spawns. It's been 10-15 minutes of me searching around. There has been nothing that spawned in this entire area. Not a single thing. There's a massive open field over there. I don't remember exactly where it was. I'm completely turned around from where I was. There's a big open field over there. Nothing spawned in it. There's nothing. So this game is still beyond the point of broken on spawns. Like, they came out with an expansion. There's the first thing I've seen that spawned this entire time. The direwolf. So it's... There's just nothing. Like, I don't even know how you're supposed to complete missions. The way I did things in the past was I literally let the game run for an hour before I started recording. Then the problem that comes up is the audio desyncs because it's unoptimized. This patch supposedly did a lot of optimization things, so I don't know if that'll still be a thing, so you'll be able to know if you hear the audio desynced right now. It's still not optimized, because that happens in games that are not optimized. But there is a new dude I did find that's up here. I think this is actually the guy that I saw on their screenshot. Mm-hmm. It's one of the new things. Ghost orchids obtained. I mean, technically I already have that, don't I? I think I have that, yeah. Complete the mission. Please unequip quest items. What? Oh, they're right here. Alright, complete the mission. Uh-huh. Mushrooms obtained? I don't think I have those there. No, I don't. Okay. Mushrooms I don't have enough. How many do you want? I don't know. Little garden set up here. Yeah, this is a person that I don't remember seeing before. I don't remember these side quests either. But yeah, I'm not sure exactly how you're supposed to do a mission when nothing spawns. It may be entirely different on a server that runs all the time, but if you're trying to do a solo play, if you're trying to do a custom game, your own settings of servers, you're kind of just screwed. It's literally a dire wolf. And 15 minutes of freaking game time is what spawned. There's no way to adjust that. The spawn rate, there's no way to... It's been a complaint I've seen of people multiple times on the Steam reviews. So I don't even know how to progress the actual story. Which is just... Yeah, I don't know. This is what I'm saying. Like, I don't know if I'll end up doing more than one video on this. Because it just bothers me so much. And it's such a just... broken experience. Like, why is this an issue? How is this still an issue? There's so many little things here and there in this game that I feel like should be addressed before you come out with another expansion. Like, little things like the freaking server settings, the admin options. You see so many survival games that have these options that you can change and adjust and do all this stuff with, but they put such a small limit on it in this. Or things like your flight speed of this thing, you can increase, but it'll increase the flight speed of all the enemies, which... Why? I don't know. I personally... I've had enough of this as I can today. Let me know if you guys want to see more. I'll come back and do more. The audio may be desynced, like I said, if I do. Because I'll have to let the game run for about an hour before I can actually play it. So stuff will spawn. But for now, yeah, I'm going to end it here. So, thank you so much for watching. I know some people do enjoy the game. It has mostly positive and recent reviews on Steam. And the fact that it's on Xbox and PlayStation, I don't know if maybe there's different setups on those. But, as far as I know, official server PvP is just a nightmare because it's just unbalanced. Official servers PvE... You used to be able to blink into buildings or something and steal people's stuff. I don't know if you still can. So, I don't know. There's just so many things that I feel like need to be addressed that have never been addressed. I'm so annoyed by this bear thing. Like, the fact that there was a bear and then it's just not there. And the fact that nothing spawned. Oh, yeah. Alright, but yeah. I'm going to leave it here for now. So, thank you so much for watching. And I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye for now.